GameCubes and PS2s are a lot more sophisticated than I thought, or at least like initially remembered. So yeah, it was stuck in an infinite low thing, and I took a chance. Like I ended, I mean, I paused the recording, but I took a chance and like just opened up the tray, cleaned the disc a bit, then did it back in, and yeah, it just picked back up right here, similar to the whole like blue screen thing that was plaguing Pikmin 2. So yeah, I'm shocked that, you know, it was able to just instantly load back up, but hey, okay, cool, I ain't complaining. You know, they made some good systems back then, huh? Well, I was not expecting that, but okay, whatever. Because, I mean, hell with the Wii, you know, if like the moment you ejected the game, that was it. It didn't, like, suspend the thing. So it's kind of amazing that the GameCube was able to, like, have the disc tray open and, like, you can remove the game and still, like, play or, like, load back up where you were. I mean, hell, that was a big thing with Animal Crossing. I mean, to be fair, like, I think the entirety of that game was loaded into RAM. So that's why, like, if you remove the Animal Crossing disc from your GameCube, you could just still play it, like, flawlessly. But okay, whatever. It's a sloppily written note. To get to the surveillance rooms in the middle of this complex, you have to use the corpse disposal chutes in the cells. However, on the first and second floors, these cells are locked. That's so the kids wouldn't discover them. So you have to get to the first floor from one of the cells on the third floor. I know how to do it, but it's really a pain. Also, the lights only work on the third floor. This is so convoluted, but okay. I'm not going to go through there just yet. I didn't accomplish much of anything. We can go here. I know there's a door on the other side, but we got a ladder. Okay, wall creatures, I'm just going to, you know, nope on out of here. Have to be semi-silent because, you know, no radio to tell me if I'm nearing evil, and that is locked. Okay, well, I have no choice. Do I just keep running, or do I take that little ladder that's right there? I need to stop pressing triangle. I'll try this ladder. I'm seriously, like, just stuck in the habit of pressing triangle. Door open, it seems locked from the inside. Yeah, let's just keep going further down. I think one of them said something about basement 2. First floor basement is the scariest place. There's a kitchen in the northeast, but next door in the northwest is a death chamber. And the surveillance room is in the middle. You have to use the disposal room. First and second floor cells are locked. Wait, because we discover them, so you only hit, so you have to get to the first floor from one of the cells on the third floor. But I was already on the first floor. Let's go back this way. What? Oh my god, I am just so used to pressing triangle to exit the map again. So where am I now? Like, well, I mean, obviously I'm in, like, the lowest floor. Oh, these guys. Nope, stop. What you get. Oh, really? No, you cannot escape your fate. And that's how we deal with that. Well, we have a hole in the wall. I'm so glad these guys don't do a lot of damage. Doesn't seem to be much of anything in here, though. You know, aside from that pipe back to the real world. Nope. Aha. Call me the exterminator. We got a door right there. Oh my god. Triangle. Ugh. You have a door right there. Thought I saw a sign. Is my mind playing tricks on me? It could be. Oh, no, yeah, there's a sign right there. It's a key. You got the Walter... And by Walter, I mean water. Water prison exit key. Key found in the water wheel room, 2-floor basement. Up is carved into it. So might that be an elevator key? Something written on the plate. Turn on the lights in the 3rd floor cells. Turn this water wheel. Remember that the water must flow in the direction of the water wheel. Of course, to open the sluice gate on the roof. Yo, this place seems all kinds of complicated. There is also, like, no rhyme or reason to my exploration. I'm just moving around. Yeah, I have a bad feeling about this place. Transformer isn't working. This looks like prime boss fight territory, not to mention this seal right here. Yeah, something major is gonna happen here. Alright, I have an exit key, and then... Like, I think I am just going to focus on exploration now, and then I'll try piecing together the different memos I found after the fact. No, you hit me. You hit me. You must die. Told you it had to die. Okay. So, the question here is, am I going to keep pressing the wrong button? But no. Do I run to the end of this section to see what I can find and hopefully not get killed? I am the Usain Bolt of Silent Hill. Okay, where am I now? Oh, right there. Okay. Yo. Okay, hug the wall. Don't waste your time on them because they just keep coming back. And I'm all the way back up. Okay, all right. So that area is all the same. It's just you have like that one, I mean, not one thing, but you have those ladders there to sort of help you out. Like quickly navigate between the different areas so you don't have to keep running up and down the stairs. Gotcha. Use the water prison exit key. Well, yeah, that's an exit, all right. So, it looks like I'm on the roof. I don't hear evil, but I'm being careful because I do not want to get knocked off this thing. Nope. Okay, that thing should be dead. I'm just being cautious just in case one of those guy. I probably should be using these ladders for quick travel. This put me, no, that doesn't put me. Oh, that's down there is where I came from. Okay. There doesn't seem to be anything of importance here. So is this the second floor then? Yes, it is. But I hear evil, so I'm gonna turn right back around. I'm not gonna take that ladder up, but I still just wanna explore this place. See, I don't know if he can fall off, but I don't want to test out that possibility. Okay. And I assume this is going to be the third floor. And then after that, we're going to have the roof. Wrong button again. Okay, I just hear water dripping there. Just getting an idea of where everything is. Like I said, once I've explored everything, then we'll start trying to piece everything together and solve these puzzles. I do not like this angle, though. Watch there be something like just insane on the roof, though. Come on. Come on, don't do this. Don't be in an infinite loop. Oh my god, another infinite loop, really? Give it a few more seconds, but okay. Well, at least I know I can safely, like, open up the disc tray and then close it again without having to stop the recording session. So I guess that's a positive for me. I can treat this like the Pikmin 2 LP, but... ooh. Like, I don't know, it's gonna be annoying to have to do what I did with Pikmin 2 with this. Constantly. Okay, yeah, this is why I try to avoid buying used copies of games. And in my defense, I did try to find a new copy of this, but oh my god, they were not affordable at all. Like, I was lucky to find this used copy for, like, I think I paid 30 for it? Or at least at the upper end of $20, because I don't know, it's like this game is relatively hard to find compared to the other Silent Hills. I don't know, anyway, the door won't open, locked from the inside. So what's all the way back here? There's a handle here. Not yet, because I just want to see some stuff here. So to turn on the lights on the third floor, turn the water wheel in basement 2. But first I have to open the sluice gate on the roof. Okay, so by doing this, I'll be able to have lights on the third floor. So having lights on the third floor help me out in any way. Because to get to the surveillance room, you have to get to it from the first and second floor. Oh wait, no, one of the cells on the third floor can do it as well. Also, the lights only work on the third floor. Okay, so by activating the lights on the third floor, I should be able to find the way to get into the surveillance room. Okay. So then what will you tell me? Because you said the scariest place was the first floor basement. Oh yeah, because I did hear evil in basement 1 and then I immediately exited out. But there is a kitchen there and a death chamber. I have to punch in the right numbers, but it's too dark to even see the panel. But the lights only work on the third floor. Let's turn this handle, see what'll happen. Because, I mean, I'm opening the sluice gate now. It sucks I'm going to have to go all the way back down to the basement, though, to activate the water wheel. But, hey, them's are the breaks. At least we have these ladders for quick travel. That is the... Yeah, okay, that seems to be it for everything up here. Now, here's the thing. Should I also, while I'm going back down, explore the second, third, and basement 1 floors? Third should be fine. I didn't hear any, like, thing creeping around in there, but, floor 2 and basement 1... those would be kind of sketchy. Are you serious, bro? I might have to find another cheap used copy of this game. Either that or take the disc to, like, somebody that can, like, I forgot what the term is, but, like, you know, some game stores will, like, just resurface. Yeah, I think it is resurface. Like, resurface your disc to get out the scratches and stuff. Because there are home remedies that I've seen, but those have varying levels of success and can, like, end up screwing up your game. And I don't want that. Because, yeah, I mean, even though I did get this game from a pretty reputable seller on eBay. When I got the game, it was like, oh my god, the back is like so scratched up. No wonder he didn't have any pictures of the back. Okay, we're back. I'll just take these ladders down. I think I will just go ahead and explore a bit as I'm going down. I'll come to terms with the fact that I can't do everything here just now. Wait, the lights are on. Or at least in this cell. And none of this is examinable. Oh, okay. Yo. Ew. Well, that looks evil. Let's wait before we do that. Okay, Well, that's one situation I'm glad I don't record my LPs with a face cam. Okay, let's jump down the hole. Let's see what this will accomplish. I am not doing this nearly in the way that I feel I should. I'm going completely off the game plan that I had set up for myself. But now we're on the first floor. Lock is broken. Okay, basement one. Oh shit! Okay. Oh fuck! No! Get no! What the fuck? Okay. That's the shower room. We will never return there again. The fuck? Well, we unlock this. Oh god. Okay, oh no. Okay. They weren't lying when they said this is dangerous. Oh, so to get to the other side of these rooms on basement one, I have to go down the holes. Okay, I assume there's going to be like holes in on each side of, or like in rooms on each side of floor three that'll take me down here. Gotcha. What is this? Oh, there was a note. I skipped through that. I have a tendency of tapping X. This place continues to deteriorate. The doors to a number of cells no longer open. As a result, the kids inside can no longer go outside, but the less they know about that, the better. So wait, was this a juvenile facility? Then why is there a freaking adult here? I can't open the doors, but from this room I can watch them get more and more emaciated each day. With no food and never showering themselves, they turn into smelly little gray lumps in there. Following the suggestion of an engineer, we've disposed of the corpses by digging a hole below the cells. Since each floor of this building can be rotated independently, we can dispose of the bodies without the others noticing by aligning each cell with a body in it vertically. P.S. Chief, I bet you're just dying to see the interrogation room behind the kitchen. I understand your feelings, but have you noticed? There are three rooms with bloody beds. Okay, one is the first floor, one is on the second floor, and one is on the third floor. If you line these three rooms up, then it's bingo. Yo, this prison is a lot more complicated than I initially thought. So So wait, this is the surveillance room? Wow, how antiquated is this? Oh wait, are there different surveillance rooms per floor? So I'm gonna have to remember like which thing. Oh my god, I wish I could do memos on this. Thankfully, there doesn't seem to be anything useful in that room. Okay, and there's a hole in there and a bloody bed. So my whole hypothesis was correct. Wait, this is first floor. Where's that guy we saw? There's a hole there. There he is. Hey, dude. Hey. Okay, then. Or he could just be a guard or caretaker. Oh, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna have to remember like where the bloody beds are on each floor. And line them up. I have no qualms of using the video game footage that I'm recording, like just watching it back, because this seems complicated. And yep, that's how I rotate the floors. Oh, there's a note in there, though. Oh, crap. There's a bloody bed. Okay, there's two bloody beds. Oh, I should probably. Okay. But wait, there's holes. Oh, but yeah, that's right. They said they dug holes and dropped the bodies through. Okay. So this document say, to keep a close eye on the kids, it's important to keep the cells well lit. The lights on the third floor were originally bought as searchlights. As a precaution against the blackout, they were set up to run on a private generator. There's a hydroelectric generator in the basement. To light up the first and second floor is used to corpse disposal chutes. Since each floor of this building can be rotated, you can light up any of the cells by matching up the holes. Repeating this periodically is an effective way to keep the kids fearful and well behaved. P.S. Chief, if you turn the handle in the middle of this room, you can easily rotate the cells. You can't rotate the first floor, so align the second and third floors with the first floor cell as a bloodstained bed. By the way, if you use the peephole in this room, it's easy to make sure you're doing it right. Give it a try, also please don't forget to open the sluice gate on the roof. Yo, this is. Wow. I was not expecting this level of like complexity. I mean, when you break it up, when you break it down, it doesn't seem that awful, but still, this is like a lot to take in. And I kind of like that. I kind of like that. You know, like this whole area is one big puzzle. You're piecing it together. The secret number for getting through the door in the back of the kitchen this month is 0302. Okay, so this is completely independent of the forest area. Gotcha. 0302. Well, I don't have to remember that because he's going to put it in his scrapbook. And just for my purposes. Yeah, I see you, wall slugs. Oh, there's a memo in there, too. Okay, I'm going to have to just get over my fear next recording session and go in these rooms and read these memos. I want all the memos. I must learn all the lore of this game. Oh, I am also like just so peeking the mic right now. I am so sorry. And oh wait, no, yeah, because I was in that room. I was trying to read everything and it wouldn't let me. It's not a bloody bed. That's a bloody bed. Okay. All right, this doesn't seem that difficult for me to do in the long run. Okay. But I'm not going to set him up now. I'm just going to go down, go through my hole in the wall, save the game, and call it a day. But at least I know how to easily get here. But wait, this is basement one. Are there other doors here? There's nothing else in the shower room. Because they were saying, like, the torture room and the kitchen are in basement one. But the other room, like whatever room that is here, is locked from the inside. So obviously, I mean, that means I'm going to have to jump down through the holes to get there. But yeah, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. Oh, and I guess while I'm here, I can turn on the lights. Light a candle. Yo, I hear you, you evil monstrosities, but I'm just gonna ignore you. I am so on edge. Okay. Yeah, before I end things off, while it's still fresh on my mind, I'm gonna activate whatever it is down here to turn on the lights on the third floor. Please don't tell me I have to get up. Okay, thank you. Oh, okay, that's water. That's water. I was like, static? Enemies are here, but oh wait, I don't have a radio. Okay, you already copied. Water wheel room. Okay, wait. To turn on the lights on the third floor, turn this water wheel. Or wait, were they just saying that by opening the sluice gates, I would be turning this water wheel? Is there something else in here? No. Now, there doesn't seem to be anything I can do to manipulate this water wheel here. And that door just takes me to that arena. Okay, well, we'll get to the bottom of this next time. I have an idea of what I need to do. I'm just going to do the very, very cheap thing of looking back through my footage to like pinpoint exactly where the like where the rooms are, what the memos are, so I can just like mitigate my process. I mean, well, blah. I'm gonna look back through this footage to see like those specific rooms that has those memos that I haven't checked out, like, and I'll use that to like, you know, just sort of prioritize going to those places first, and obviously I'll have an idea on like where the bloody beds are so I can move the floors around. And yeah, we'll get to the bottom of things there. Oh yeah, we also need to help that guy who's stuck. Okay, the TV is on. Don't remember turning this on. And we have a note. No, no, not your shoes. The note. What? No. The note. Scrap of red paper stuck in here. Lately, I've been feeling like my life is in serious danger. I've been through a lot in my life, but I've never felt this kind of pure animal fear. In case something happens to me, I've decided to write down what I've learned for whoever you are that's living in the apartment now. I've been investigating the mass murder that took place 7 years ago in which 10 people were killed in 10 days. They were killed in a variety of ways, but the one thing they had in common was that each corpse had the following numbers in order of their depths carved into them. Oh shit. 01121, 02121, 03121, 04121, 05121, 06121, 07121, 08121, 0921, 10121. The name of their killer was carved in as well. His name was Walter Sullivan. April 4. Oh shit. Okay, the game, it is picking up now, story-wise. What are you doing, man? Come on, man. Take your medication, man. Who are you talking to, man? He ain't talking to nobody, man. Yeah, this is getting interesting, because, what was the number? That woman, what was her name? Vanessa? I am so sorry that I've forgotten her name. But, like, she had a number, I think. That crazy dude, the chocolate milk guy, he had 7121 carved into him. Either way, things are getting interesting, and like I'm just, wow, I'm back into it. I'm, ooh. Okay, well, we spy on her just to make sure she's still there. No, but it's Robbie. Okay. And seriously, can I please turn this off? It's going to run my electric bill up. Okay, you don't remember pressing it, but turn it off. Because this is going to be... This is not going to help me out every time I come back here. Because this just reminds me of the static from the radio and whatever. Next time we go back to the prison and try to finish solving everything there. So, thank you all for watching. Have a great day and see you next time for some more Let's Play Silent Hill 4 The Room. The game is beginning to get to me a little, but hey, the story is getting real good too. Oh boy. But alright, goodbye.